Sir, can you explain to us what is this new product that you've developed?
You know, I think the general philosophy behind this product is that our armed forces have difficult terrains to operate on our eastern borders and northeastern borders with a lot of mountains, hills, etc. And if you have a lot of heavy equipment, it's difficult to transport heavy equipment.
Sure.
So we decided to make a very light equipment mounted on a vehicle and design the vehicle that can go almost anywhere, it doesn't need a road.
So all-terrain
vehicle? Yeah, all-terrain, even on a little kacha pathway, it can go through jungles,
right,
as long as there is no physical obstacle in
sure.
front of it.
Sure.
So this is what we have designed. We've designed the vehicle ourselves, we made the vehicle ourselves, we designed the gun and made the gun ourselves. This gun is weighing 900 kilograms. It's a 105 artillery weapon. It fires up to 17 kilometers and the vehicle can run almost at 100-120 kilometers on road and off-road at about 70 odd kilometers.
Excellent.
Per hour. So, you know, it's something that we want, we believe that it's something the armed forces is looking for.
Right.
Something that's mobile, something that's light and something that has lethality. And it's got all the electronics, fire control system and everything that you have in an artillery gun.
So basically you've developed it for the Indian Army.
Yes.
And then it's also got export potential.
Yeah, we had a huge number of people here from morning, you know, expressing interest in this and of course our standard 155-52 caliber gun.
That's right.
Because, you know, there's a whole lot of countries that are running out of weapons.
Yeah.
And there are very few people who can supply weapons.
Right, that's true. And so India can become one of the export hubs.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you are one of the leading
especially in artillery,
there.
I think India right. can become the producer of artillery for the world in the next 5 years.
So, and you will be leading the charge, as we know.
Inside.
But one final question, sir. Make in India has been a mantra for some time. But what does it need to get a little more boost?
You know, I believe that the Honorable Prime Minister started the Make in India initiative in December 2014. And I think, you know, he really created a lot of passion in all of us.
Sure.
At least I became quite passionate with the whole Make in India process.
Sure.
And there were many other businessmen who became passionate about it. And if you looked at us in 2014, you know, in a defense expo, we didn't even have 1/10 of the products that we had. Okay? So the Make in India initiative has at least created a direction for industry
sure.
to, you know, invest, develop and create products with your own technology.
True.
Because there's one thing that you get a contract and you get a partner and you're making, you know, doing some assembly work
sure.
and things like that. It's another thing that you develop the technology yourselves. So you own the technology and then you can be a global leader in that technology.
And you've always believed in that.
Yeah.
You always
yeah.
cite that
That's
example
always been
of
my
that Second
philosophy.
World War...
Yeah. And I think
example.
This is the greatest impetus that the Make in India program has given. I think the next step has to be fulfill the Honorable Prime Minister's wishes that by 2025 you have a $5 trillion defense economy in this country, which means our services have to buy more from domestic production.
That's right. And they will, I guess. Thank you very much, sir. Thanks
All
for
right.
your time.